A project which was initially intended to be a remedial education initiative for some students has since then evolved into a full-blown music annex.
I want to say that I am pleased and proud to be associated with this project, in that as a parliamentary representative at the time, I actually began the construction of the project, and Mr. Judah of JAG completed it. I want to commend him as a corporate citizen for doing so. And I just want to say that I think such projects are very important, because we sometimes emphasize only the academics, but in our curriculum we should also look at the creative arts, sports and other developmental aspects.
The building was funded by corporate citizen Julian Ajuda, who operates a tour company in Bosseju by the name of JAG. Mr. Ajuda has also pledged to help with the furnishing of the annex, as he works alongside the school's principal in the development of the youth.
Music plays a very significant role in the life of our students at the Gros-Islet Primary School. We have participated in many competitions, and our children have done very well. We have a very committed music teacher, Mrs. Lambert, and it gives us joy and pleasure to hand over this building for Mrs. Lambert. Mrs. Lambert is the Gros-Islet Primary School music teacher.
The ceremony was also an opportunity to thank Mr. Ajuda for his contribution to the development of the Gros-Islet constituency.
As you know, the Gros-Islet constituency, the schools there are very good in terms of the skills and talents in the area of music and performing arts and visual arts. And with the launch of the Frank Noble Center, we are really hoping that all the schools can come together and showcase the talent of our students in the Gros-Islet constituency.
The minister encouraged more corporate citizens to get involved in the development of St. Lucia's youth. For the DBS News World, I am Jenna Anne Gaston.